Well, Brennan, we have reached my favorite portion of the game show. And as someone who has studied The Amazing Race for years, it is always fun for me to have the chance to use my knowledge of the show to create a game based all around The Amazing Race trivia stored in my head. It is time for the game of the day.
Game of the day.
Now, as I mentioned earlier, Kevin told me that I have to amp up my game for you because of how knowledgeable you are with Amazing Race facts, especially regarding the Amazing Race period. Well, I did my best to give you a true Amazing Race trivia challenge. So, Brennan, your game is none other than the same game I played with Kevin. This is Race Route Recap. Race Route Recap. And because your first destination on the Amazing Race period was Africa, the background music for this game will be Africa by Toto. And here's how the game works. In front of me are the names of the 10 Amazing Race destinations you traveled to during Season 1, which are the United States, South Africa, Zambia, France, Tunisia, Italy, India, Thailand, China, and back to the United States. Each destination corresponds to a multiple-choice Amazing Race trivia question. But even though these questions are related to the destinations of the first race, the questions themselves aren't necessarily about the first race. They could be about any aspect from the history of the Amazing Race that are associated with the Season 1 destinations. You're going to answer the questions in route order from question 1 about the United States all the way to question 10 about the United States. And Brennan, if you can answer 6 out of the 10 questions correctly, you will cross the finish line first and be deemed a winner. And one more element to mention. After getting your first correct answer, you will receive a fast forward, which means if you hear a question you don't know the answer to, you could use the fast forward and automatically receive the correct answer point to that question. And in case you were wondering why you get the fast forward after only one correct answer, well, on the Amazing Race period, you and Rob earned your fast forward on leg 1. So I feel it's only appropriate that you earn your Race Route Recap fast forward after answering one question correctly. Also, just to let you know, Kevin unfortunately did not win Race Route Recap when he played. Kevin got 4 correct answers, which includes the correct answer he earned from using his fast forward. So you can add another first to your Amazing Race resume and become the first ever winner of Race Route Recap right here on the game show. In addition, all of the questions you are about to face are different questions than the ones Kevin faced, in case you were wondering. So Brennan, almost 20 years after traveling the race route for real, are you ready to travel the Season 1 race route from the comforts of your own chair?
I'm ready.
Then let's play Race Route Recap. And of course, we're going to start with the United States. And here comes your first question. Which of these Amazing Race seasons featured a starting line in New York City? Is it Season 8, Season 18, or Season 28?
I'm going to go with Season 28.
Lock that in?
Yes.
Unfortunately, with Season 8.
Season 8.
Season 8 was the family edition of The Amazing Race, and it started at Empire Fulton Ferry State Park. And that was near the Brooklyn Bridge. Season 18, Unfinished Business, started in Palm Springs. And Season 28 started at the team's homes for the first time ever. Brad fact.
Yes, I do remember that now.
But no worries. We'll just start new. Here comes your South Africa question. During Leg 5 of The Amazing Race Season 7, teams traveled to the Orlando Children's Home in what Johannesburg township? Is it Deep Sloot, Soweto, or Orange Farm?
I'm going to go with Soweto.
You locking that in?
Yes.
Well, I am happy to say that it is Soweto.
All right. Got one right. I got my fast forward.
Yes, you have your fast forward. Soweto is the largest South African township by population, in case you'd like to know. Brad fact. So you have your fast forward, which means anytime you don't like a question, you can use your fast forward and I'll give you the correct answer point for that question. Remember, just like on the race, you can only use it once.
Okay.
This is question 3 of 10, and this is about Zambia. 5 more for a win. During the near option of the Leg 2 detour on The Amazing Race Season 1, teams had to capture photos of 3 out of 5 animals at the national park. Which of these was not one of the 5 animals in the provided list of animals? Is it rhino, giraffe, or hippo?
It's hippo.
You locking that in?
Locking that in.
Do you remember what the five animals were?
Well, giraffe and rhino, impala, zebra. I'm going to say water buffalo is the fifth.
Well, you are right on everything. Hippo is the correct answer, and you're right. Giraffe, zebra, rhino, impala, and water buffalo.
When Kevin said I have good, amazing race memory, it's I remember my season. I wouldn't call myself a super fan because I only watch every season one time, so that's why everything kind of runs together. But my season, for whatever reason, I guess because it was such a life-changing experience, I remember everything pretty well.
But this game is going to prove yourself wrong that you do know other seasons.
Yeah, well, let's keep going.
So you have two correct answers, and here comes your next question. This is about France. The Amazing Race Season 10 was the first time after Season 1 to visit which of these Paris landmarks? The Eiffel Tower, the Arc de Triomphe, or Notre Dame?
The Eiffel Tower.
Are you locking that in?
I'll lock that in.
It is the Eiffel Tower.
All right, good. I didn't remember exactly the season, but I do remember that they went back to the Eiffel Tower.
Yeah, the Eiffel Tower was visited during leg 12 of season 10. Brad fact. Three down, three to go. This is your Tunisia question.
Okay.
At the beginning of the fourth leg during the Amazing Race season 1, the teams received a small flag of Tunisia. Where is the crescent moon-like image located on the Tunisian flag? Is it in the upper left-hand corner, inside a center circle, or inside a center star?
The moon and the star, I believe, are in a center circle. Locking it in.
That is correct.
All right.
You have four down, and I know you're a big strategist. If you get one more correct without the fast forward, you could technically win.
All right. Let's see what we can do.
We're now on question six. Here's your Italy question. During leg 7 of season 12 in Empoli, Italy, a fast-forward challenge required both team members to get a permanent tattoo of what? Is it the letters T-A-R for The Amazing Race, the number 12 for Season 12, or the letters F-F for Fast Forward?
I am going to say it is F-F for Fast Forward.
Are you locking that in?
I'm locking it in.
Why do you think it's F-F?
Because when you mentioned all three, that was my first inclination. I've always learned to go with your first inclination.
Well, that first inclination of yours is absolutely correct.
All right. I like it.
You now have five correct answers, which means you could technically win right now if you use the fast forward on the next question. But let's see if you can win this game without having to use the fast forward.
I'm all for it, yeah.
Here comes your India question. This is question 7. How many times has the famous head-shaving fast-forward challenge in India appeared in the American version of The Amazing Race? Is it 2, 3, or 4?
I think we're going to have to win this by using my fast-forward because, I mean, obviously I remember when Uchenna and Joyce did it, when Joyce shaved her head, but I can't remember beyond that. My answer would be 2, but I don't know for sure, so I'm going to use my fast-forward.
All right, you're going to use your fast forward, which means that is your 6th correct answer. So congratulations, Brennan. You have won this game of Race Route Recap.
All right, I like it. Thanks.
Now, you'd have said 2, and good thing you used your fast forward. It's actually 3.
Is it? Okay.
Yeah, the head shaving challenge appeared during leg 9 of season 5 in Kolkata, which was the first time they ever did it. Leg 8 in season 7 in Jodhpur, and that was when Uchenna and Joyce faced that challenge. And as a switchback during leg 10 of season 20 in Karthala, India. Brad fact! And since there are only 3 questions left, Brennan, let's continue our journey with question 8. And this is your Thailand question. During which Amazing Race season that visited Thailand did a team win the fast forward for eating a bowl of fried crickets and grasshoppers, a traditional Thai meal? Is it season 9, season 14, or season 19?
This one's just a complete guess. I'm going to go with season 9.
Are you locking that in?
Locking that in.
Well, it was a complete guess, but your instincts were correct again. It is season 9.
Right. That time I did once again go with my first instinct, but that maybe was just because you said season 9 first. Who knows?
Which now means that technically you have won this game without the use of the fast forward. That is your 6th official correct answer without a fast forward.
All right. Nice.
And by the way, the fast forward was won by eventual season 9 winners BJ and Tyler. Brad fact! Would you like to see BJ and Tyler on the all-winner season if it eventually came about?
if we are on it for sure, then yeah, I'd like to see them.
Well, you have 7 correct answers and you have 2 questions left. So let's see how well you do with China. During season 11 in Macau, China, the remaining teams participated in which of these historic Amazing Race challenges? The longest zip line, the highest skydive, the tallest tower jump.
So Macau, China is a large city. So I'm going to go with C, the tower jump. Locking that in.
Excellent reasoning. It is the tallest tower jump.
All right, we'll take it.
During Leg 11, which was the All-Star season, for the Roblox, one team member had to complete a 660-foot sky jump off of the Macau Tower, which was the highest tower jump performed in the history of the Amazing Race. Brad fact! So you have 8 correct answers, and this is the final question. We have made it around the world already. Can you believe it?
That was way faster than my first time.
And so much less energy needed. So here we go. You have 8 correct answers. This is to win you 9 out of 10. The United States. Here's the question. The Amazing Race Season 6 was the second season to feature the starting line and the finish line in the same city. Which city was it? Is it A, Los Angeles, B, Chicago, or C, San Francisco?
I remember that season pretty well, too. But I can't remember which of those cities it was. So I know season 2 finished in San Francisco. So that was close enough to 6 that I'm going to eliminate that. Part of me wants to say Los Angeles because, of course, there were a lot of races that started in Los Angeles. But I do know there was an early season. I remember them finishing in Chicago. I'm going to go with Chicago.
Are you locking in Chicago?
Locking it in.
Well, you were right. San Francisco was season 2. Los Angeles, they started at Dodger Stadium in season 4, but season 6 started and ended in Chicago. You are correct.
Yeah. It's so funny that you mentioned season 4 being in Los Angeles. I should have remembered that because I was at Dodger Stadium for the start of season 4. And now that I mentioned that, I was at the Santa Monica Pier for the start of season 5. So it would have been crazy if they did 3 seasons in LA in a row. So anyway, it doesn't matter. I got it right.
Wait, so what do you mean you were at the start? They invited you?
So what happened was for season 4, Rob and I were hired by the TV show Extra to cover the starting line. We are here in Dodger Stadium, ready for the start of Amazing Race 4. They waited until the show was ready to air, but we were actually there. We were down on the field and we interviewed Phil and had Phil do a mock elimination, which never made it on Extra. But yeah, we did that for the TV show. And then the next season, just because we had been there at season 4 and we had friends in production, we heard it was starting at the Santa Monica Pier and we asked someone and they said, yeah, come on down. So it was cool. We were at the start line for seasons 4 and 5, obviously not like season 27 because we were just in the background with production.
Have you ever thought about getting back into interviewing for entertainment news?
Not anymore. After Amazing Race, I realized I just got paid $500,000 to be myself and be on camera and travel around the world. I'm like, how cool is that? And I remember one of the producers that we did the interviews with, even though, like I said, I tend to ramble, he was like, you've done this before, haven't you? I'm like, nope. And he goes, yeah, you should consider hosting afterwards. And so what made it different back then is we did have a true 15 minutes of fame. Like now, if you're on season 32 of The Race, it's fun while you're on, but nobody remembers you as soon as it's over. But because the shows were so new back then, Rob and I got calls from casting directors and producers and agents, and you actually had the opportunity to possibly do some stuff in television. And so we had both just won $500,000. So we quit our legal jobs and gave the entertainment business a shot. And I did for a while. I went back to being a lawyer, but continued doing that on the side, you know, going to auditions and all that because the opportunities were there living in Los Angeles. And then it just got to a point where I just liked being able to go back to the foundation of being a lawyer, and I knew where my paycheck was coming from and I had a steady job, and so I left those behind. And as a matter of fact, I went back to the same law firm, and for a while I was an independent contractor because I was still doing Hollywood stuff. And when I finally became a salaried employee again, the managing partner said, you got to leave your Hollywood dreams behind. So it's really not an interest anymore, but it definitely was for a while.
So with 9 correct answers, and 8 of which you did on your own, Brennan, congratulations, you have won this game of Race Route Recap.
I love it. Thanks so much. The only thing I'll say, I guess being a perfectionist, I'm a little disappointed that I missed the one that I did without using my fast forward, because I thought about it afterwards. Season 8, the family edition, Kevin and Drew were hot dog vendors in New York City, so I should have remembered that that race started in New York.
Well, as a perfectionist myself, I can honestly say that you did a fantastic job at this game, and I hope you had fun playing it.
Well, I appreciate it. I definitely enjoyed it, and I feel like I would have enjoyed it even if I hadn't done that well, because it's always fun reliving things like that.
It certainly is. And that was the game of the day, Race Route Recap. Race Route Recap.